Today is the last Sunday of the current liturgical year. Next Sunday will be the beginning of Advent. And we always celebrate the feast, the solemnity of Christ the King at the end of the liturgical year. It was instituted by Pope Pius XI in the early decades of the 20th century at a time when there's tremendous political ferment in Europe and many countries were tilting towards some form of absolutism. So think of the communist takeover in Russia, the rise of fascism in Italy, the rise of Nazism in Germany, the dictatorship in Spain. All of that led the Pope to reaffirm liturgically and theologically that Jesus Christ is King. And it goes all the way back to the proclamation of Peter on Pentecost morning when he stands up and says that this Jesus whom you have crucified, God has made him both Lord and Messiah. So to preach Jesus as Lord is the heart of the kerygma, the proclamation of the gospel. And if Jesus is Lord, it means that no one else is. It means that all human power is relativized in relationship to the absolute spiritual sovereignty of Jesus Christ and the gospel. All that reminds us then of the poignancy of the witness of the martyrs, because the martyrs were faced with that fundamental question, who is Lord and Messiah of my life? So in the early Roman Empire, if a Christian was caught out, to save his life, all he had to do was offer a pinch of incense to a statue of the emperor who is worshiped as God. Christian in good conscience could not do that because the emperor is not God. Only Jesus is God. Only God is God. So they were faced with a fundamental choice, to apostatize in order to save their life or to give up their life rather than their faith and to affirm that yes, indeed, Jesus Christ is Lord and Messiah. In many ways, we're faced with the same situation today. You know, we live in a culture that in many ways demands our obeisance to things that are not in line with church teaching. And if we dare to get out of line and question its sovereignty, we're often attacked, or today we would say canceled, certainly criticized as somebody not in step with modern culture, that in many ways Christianity and the church are seen as old-fashioned, that we need to get over this way of doing things in order to make real progress. For us as Christians, we will always faithfully, perseveringly, lovingly, sacrificially cling to our conviction of the truth of the universe, that Jesus Christ is Lord and Savior. And when we acknowledge him as Lord and Savior, we are set free from our sins and the power of death. So to serve this King does not oppress us, does not diminish us, does not make us simply slaves of a whimsical tyrant. To be obedient to Christ is to be set free, to become fully ourselves, to become adopted children of the Father, to know that our mission in life is to love, know, and serve God, and that we are made heirs to the kingdom of heaven. So a very unusual King it is that we serve. His crown is not of gold, but of thorns. He reigns not from a throne of jewels, but from the throne of the cross. And he came only to love and to serve and lay down his life for us. So we see in the gentle kingship of Christ what true sovereignty and power look like. Not power for the sake of self-exaltation, but power in the harness of service, power in the service of love. So on this feast of Christ the King, we affirm once again his sovereignty, his reign over us. Jesus Christ is Lord and Messiah, and that means all human power is relative to his divine, gentle, loving power.